Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. I'm talking about vortexing our Sculptra. So many questions on Sculptra. Sculptra is an art, and everyone has a little different method of doing it, using it, diluting it, and injecting it in different depths. There are some commonalities. One of those is swirling, mixing, and avoiding the all-dreaded clog. If I'm in a large group and I'm training, out of 100 people, if I ask them why they failed or stopped or don't like using Sculptra, the number one answer still is clogging. Mixing the Sculptra, as a side note on dilutions, really depends on the depth, the skin, and the skin quality. So it's a long conversation. When we have the vial, the PLLA, carboxymethylcellulose, and mannitol are all in that vial. When we swirl them, especially if we're doing a number of vials, or we don't swirl them long enough, the product collects on the bottom, and a lot of the PLLA ends up being wasted. That's one issue. The vortex will help swirl that product and get it uniform so that we have a nice uniform PLLA blend if we draw up from the middle of the vial. We invert the vial for about 20 to 30 seconds prior to taking the product out. And then all the carboxymethylcellulose, which is mainly the clogging factors, go to the top. Then we draw the product out from the middle of the vial and we place it in the syringe without getting the product that's sitting at the top, because those are our clogging factors. This greatly will reduce clogging, and the number one needle to use is a 25 gauge, 1.5 inch. If we go to a 23 gauge, we get a lot more bruising, and for some reason, significantly it increases the discomfort. So the 25, still the one we want to use. If you use the vortex, it will greatly help reduce the clogging, make it more comfortable for the injector, and two other factors. Don't hit bone, because periosteum will then clog, and then sucking back on the syringe. When you pull back, the beauty of Sculptra, it's a water. We see if we're in a vessel, you don't have to pull back hard because of that water. If it's a hyaluronic acid or calcium, we do need to pull back harder and longer. But with Sculptra, the minute you see a little air bubble in the hub of the needle, that's all you need, because remember, it's a water, and if you're pulling back, blood is liquid, you will see it immediately. So the vortexing Sculptra is one great method to stop clogging, among others. Join us on this YouTube channel for continued helpful tips on Sculptra, and also over on Instagram for great before and afters and tips as well. Thanks for joining me today. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.